Recording. Again, another little vlog of me sitting here at my great mechanical harp, the pianoforte. Yes. Thank you. Well, it's Friday, the 24th of June, getting near the end of the month now, last quarter of the moon. Oh yeah. It is also the 26th day of the moon, that same moon that we're getting into the end of, very much the end of. And it is the fourth day of summer since the solstice turned on Tuesday. The days are long, but they're beginning to turn back. Solstice means the sun stops, and it has done that. The sun came as far north as it could, and it stopped. And now it's starting to lean very slowly back to the south. In September, the sun will be going full gangsters, south, south, south. But now it's just beginning to leave its northernmost point in the sky. Yeah. That's the holiday of solstice. Dry vermouth. When I finish this little drink, I'll have a little bit of vermouth left, and I'll probably add either some gin or some vodka. And have myself the first martini of the day. Now, I've already had 3 glasses of wine this afternoon. And I would say I'm not fit to drive. I don't feel especially drunk, but I do feel the influence of the alcohol from the 3 glasses of wine, and now a little bit of vermouth. My name is Daniel, and I am an alcoholic. And it's been about 5 or 6 seconds since my last drink. Yeah. The story goes that Bill W. and his friends, who were the ones who gave birth to Alcoholics Anonymous, they found out that if they could just sit together and talk about it, it would help them not to drink. I remember when I first realized that it wasn't a choice. With some people, it was just a psychological or a physical addiction. Now, what's the difference between wanting something and being chemically addicted? I think about my many years of smoking tobacco cigarettes. I like to smoke the red Marlboro. But later, when I was living in Tijuana the last 9 years of my smoking life, I was smoking Mexican cigarettes. There were three or four different brands I favored. Delicado. And Del Prado was another one I liked. Del Prado. I think that was a real name. And then, of course, there were the Mexican Marlboro. And they were just a few pennies more than the Mexican cigarettes. Of course, the Marlboro in Mexico was made in Mexico from tobacco, from I don't know where, but they made it there in Mexico and they sold it for cheaper than cigarettes in the US. Anyhow, I smoked a lot of cigarettes, maybe 40 years worth. Back a day. And it was a very strong addiction. And I still feel it. I like to stand near people who are smoking so I can smell it again and get the smoke into my lungs and get the nicotine into my bloodstream and into my brain. Let's see. It's been a while since I stood by anyone who was smoking. I can't remember. Well, I do remember more than a year ago when I went to my last high school reunion. It was our 50th anniversary. And I went there, and my buddy, who I've stayed in contact through the years, partly because of Facebook, as a matter of fact, but he was smoking, and he apologized. He said, "No, don't worry, I like the smell. I used to smoke myself." That I remember doing, but that was more than a year ago. I don't remember being nearby smokers since then. But I dream about it. I still dream that I'm smoking a cigarette, and I wake up very upset that I'm smoking instead of just enjoying someone else's smoking. I wake up and I remember, oh, I'm not really smoking. I was only dreaming. Well, sometimes I play music in my dreams. It's not the same, because when we are awake, we feel this sensorium. We feel the senses of the world around us coming into our bodies and we put back out. Female deer, ray a drop of golden sun. Me a name I call myself, far a long, long way to run. So, a needle pulling thread, la, a note to follow so. Tea, a drink with jam and bread, and that will bring us back to do. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. Do, ti, la, sol, fa, mi, re, do. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. Do, ti, la, sol, fa, mi, re, do. Anyhow, this pattern of music isn't the only one. I mean, other, this is the European seven-toned scale. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. And at the beginning and the end, they are harmonic repetitions of each other. Those are all the repetitions of the repetitions of each other. Harmonically, numbers of vibrations within numbers of vibrations. Little too big, but in similar steps that get logarithmically bigger and smaller. It appears that the universe does have harmony. And that's why material objects hang together. I mean, there's a whole lot of nothing in everything, but the harmony makes it hang together as matter. So that even though theoretically this wood and this wood have much more empty space than they have any solid atoms, but if I whack them hard against each other, I will be sorry because I'll scratch. I'll maybe even break the beautiful piece of wood that's given into my care. So, yes, it's time for the martini. Hold that thought just a moment, would you? I'm back. Yes, I am. And the other note is, yeah. Well, let's see. As I recall, we were looking at the apparent solidity of the universe, and if I could whack my flute against the piano, it wouldn't be very pretty, because the solidness of stuff hits against the solidness of stuff. And in that echo of the hit, there might sometimes be music. As here, when the little hammer hits the wire on the great harp. Also holding down a mechanism that lets the harp resonate. If I turn it off, if I turn it on, there's another mechanism which is similar, but not as sustaining. And one I need a lot because I'm so damn loud. The softening mechanism. Now, I'm a noisy old loud bugger. But I try sometimes to follow a few tunes. And I'm not sure sometimes if I'm right or not, because I'm really not very professional. Thank you. Anyhow, that's something I learned when I was a boy. And that's the sort of stuff they wanted me to play. But in my mind, when I was a very young child, that sort of Broadway music was what I wanted to be able to sing. I never got around to even thinking about playing it for years and years, because the piano was just, for me, the piano was just a toy. Until when I was in my 20s, I realized that I could just play chords and started to pick out tunes. Is this the little girl I carried? Is this the little boy at play? I don't remember growing older. When did they? Yeah. Sunrise, sunset. Sunrise, sunset, swiftly fly the days. Seedlings turn overnight to sunflowers, blossoming even as we gaze. Sunrise, sunset, sunrise, sunset, swiftly fly the years, one season following another. Laden with happiness and tears. Oh, God, I sound like some sort of lounge lizard. The piano man. I could never make it as a piano player in a bar because them guys are professionals. They know how to play hundreds of songs. I think I know two. Well, maybe three. Yeah.
Thank you.
it's just a question of these notes draw me forward, and they're songs I've heard and songs I haven't heard yet. But because I'm such an amateur, there's very little hard nailed down. See, those are the two wrong notes. I wanted it to play dee 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 dee. Satisfied with the melody that you're playing, and you play it over again, you break up the song to play a piece of it over again. Going flat or sharp instead of solid. And I'm playing the standard do, re, mi, fa, sol, la. I'm playing the standard Pythagorean 8-note scale. And that is not quite what is on this one. Does have a harmonic on this note, but it doesn't have the low notes that are on the no. Has this G, B flat, C instead of so it's sort of in the G scale, but it doesn't have the same notes at the beginning that the Pythagorean European flutes do. There's a limited number of holes, you can't get some of these notes. Forgive me for boring you with all of this, and it really is kind of boring to have all this mathematics and stuff that I don't even really understand myself, but I've heard tell of it. Now, some of you musicians out there, yeah, Johnny and and Scott, Mr. Diesel, and others of you, William T. Some of you know these things way better than I do, so I can appreciate whenever you play music, you must appreciate that I think it's pretty damn good. You guys are musicians. It seems to me I forgot someone. Oh, yeah.